you were to ask me what is the one Coda skill you need to know and learn in order to really master Coda, I would say it's filters. And even if you're a seasoned Coda veteran, I guarantee you there's some tricks and tips you're gonna learn in this video. I'm gonna show you quickly the three different ways to filter in Coda: hard-coded filters, filter bars, and canvas controls, as well as why and when to use one over the other. So let's go. All right, so the first one that we're gonna look at are hard-coded filters, and these are perfect for creating specific views for specific purposes. So let's look at our tasks table here. You'll see that we just have a lot of tasks, right? They're just kind of all jumbled, they're in different statuses, and they're different urgency. Let's create two different views with a hard-coded filter for status and for urgency. So let's make a new table called completed tasks. And let's come in here, we'll put in our table. We are going to not start blank, but connect it to tasks. And what we're gonna do, normally when you have a table, you see it like this. Let's call it completed tasks. And what you're gonna do is say filter. You could go to options as well, and you'll see filter here, or you can get to it directly by just pressing filter. These are gonna be our hard-coded filters. We'll look at filter bar later, but you're gonna press add a filter. You're gonna add a filter to a column initially. And so let's go to status. Once you're in here, you'll see that you have the ability to select some, but you can change the type of filter that's happening. Notice that we're saying status is done. That's really all we need to do, right, in order to say that it's completed. But you're also able to take these filters and you're able to change the types. Is any of, or is blank, is not blank. So for example, if we said is any of, or is not done, now it's gonna show us all those. So if these were done, we're gonna say, hey, you know what, actually, no, show us where they are any of done. Now we have completed tasks. And we could take our, we could take another one and called, let's just call it tasks, right? So we're gonna do another table connected to tasks, put a hard-coded filter on this that takes the status and just says is not done. Those are what we call hard-coded filters. We'll do one more and show you urgency as well. So let's call this high priority task, right? So this is what I mean by specific views for specific purposes. You might want to have a very specific page called high priority, where you see just the tasks that are high priority, so you can come in and focus on that which matters to you. So here I have my high priority tasks. We are going to filter this table, and we're going to do it by urgency, where it is at least, is up to, is equal to. Notice I have all these different pieces here. I can say is equal to 3. Now all of a sudden I have just my urgent tasks, but I can have just my urgent and maybe I don't want to see my done tasks, obviously, right? So this is where I'd add a second filter. I can come in and say, show me on where my urgency is 3. And then I can say, or, so you'll notice this and status is not done. Now all of a sudden, all I have are urgent tasks that are still incomplete. So this and is really important, right? Because it can be or as well. Notice what happens if I put or. Those are our only two options here. If I put or, it's gonna show me all of a sudden everything again, right? Because now it's showing me whether either of these two things are true. Show me where there are 3 or show me where it's not done. So now you'll notice that I have this one. This one is not done, so it's showing. Right? So we don't want or there, we want and to be able to show us just the high priority tasks that are in progress. Now, one more thing on hard-coded filters, just like everything in Coda, we can add them to here, or we can add a formula to customize our filter in whatever way we want. For example, we could show it to where the due date dot day, our weekday name, is equal to, I could say Monday, right? So now I can show high priority tasks due on a Monday. So hopefully that just shows you that you can get as flexible as you really want or as you really like with your filters here and with your hard-coded filters. But you don't always want to use hard-coded filters. They are really just for creating these specific views because they're not easy to change. So that's where we come into other ways to filter. And this, the next one is the filter bar. I'm gonna show you that and show you why you might wanna use it instead of hard-coded filters. All right, so we just said that these hard-coded filters are not always ideal because they're very difficult to change, especially if you're not a doc maker and you don't understand the difference between and, or, and your formulas. So the next way that you can filter your tables is with something called a filter bar. So in order to filter this table, you'll notice that we already have one hard-coded filter. We can combine these. We can do both hard-coded and filter bars, and in this case we will. So let's say we wanted this table to show all tasks that have not been complete, in progress tasks, correct? But we want people to be able to come in and filter this down even more, but it might be different per user or per day or per moment. So that's where instead of going to the filter here, we're gonna say enable filter bar. You'll notice that what it's going to do when you press that is it's gonna take the first three visible columns, task name, description, and due date, and put them up there. You're able to then, you know, show different columns. So these are the columns in your table that you can filter by. So you get to choose what you want to filter. We probably don't want task name because that's just hard. We can use this normal thing to find a task name, right? If we want to find email, we can go in and find it like that. So we usually don't want the task name. We probably don't want the description. The due date is a good one. The status is good. Urgency, team, and people. These are all great pieces to filter by. So let's see what this does for us and what the options we have are. So you see here, if I go to status, for example, it's showing me the statuses that are available. So I can say, hey, you know what? Just show me the not started. And notice how couple things happened. First off, we see just tasks that are not started. Great, that's awesome. How do I get out if I want to get out? Here's your X, right? Now it's going to back and going to show me just the ones that are incomplete. But let's go back to status not started and notice a few other things. First of all, this turns blue, right? It's just indicating to you like you're filtering something by the status. I can also go, I want to see just the three or more. So now I'm seeing just not started with an urgency, and those are both blue, telling me I've seen that, and then I can reset once again. Something else to note about these, notice if I hover over this, it says changes only affect you. So if you have 10 people working on this doc at the same time, and you come in and you say, hey, show me the ones that are in progress, that will not affect anyone else, which is perfect because you don't want someone looking at their tasks and then all of a sudden everything to change for them. So the changes that you make here only affect you. So that's something beautiful about our filter bar that is different from our hard-coded filters, right? Hard-coded filters will affect everyone's view. Filter bars only affect the people that come in. Now there's a couple more things you can do. For example, notice when I put urgency is, let's go out of here. Let's say I just want to see the non-urgent ones and I just say one. Notice that doesn't do anything. That's because this option is at least. So just how we are able to change how the filter interacts in the hard-coded, we can do that here, right? I can say is equal to. So now my urgency filter bar is going to do is equal to, and now I see just my low priority tasks. These are perfect filters to use all the time because you may come in here and you only want to see the ones that are assigned to you. Now I'm seeing low priority that are just to me. So the filter bar is perfect when you want to give multiple users the ability to filter down information that's relevant to them, and it might change often. All right, the last type of filter, which honestly I think is the most fun and most flexible, is a canvas control filter. So what is your canvas? First of all, your canvas is anything that's not a table, so this is the canvas. Right, so what the canvas control filter is inputting controls here that affect how your table looks and interacts. So there's multiple ways to do this, but the easiest is simply to come and first find a column that you want a canvas control for. So let's say due date, for example. Let's say we're going to filter it. You'll come to the column options up here, go down to filter, and notice that it has edit filter, filter bar, canvas control. These are the three types of filters we talked about. When I go to canvas control, it's gonna allow me to create one. The moment I do that, you'll notice that it has this little control up here and everything's disappeared. So right now it's looking for stuff in the last 7 days. Let's change it to everything. I normally like to keep these just so they're easy to see in a little call out, and I make this into a filter. There we go. And now I can see everything. You'll notice that I can also use this to do a fixed date range, like just show me what's in January 31st to the end of February, for example, and then you'll see here we go, all these in February. So those are really easy, but you might also want to ask, is this gonna affect everyone or just me? And the answer to that is both. So if I hover over it, it says changes only affect you, but you can change that. If I right click on this control, there's two modes. There's personal and collaborative. Every control you make in the canvas defaults to personal. So this will only affect the current user. So everyone can use that control at the same time and see different information. But if you want it to affect everyone, you can change to collaborative. Now, why is this better than the due date? Right? Because the due date is select option. I can do a custom range. I can do the exact same thing here on my filter bar. The reason why canvas controls are so fun and so powerful is that you can do things that just aren't possible with the filter bar or a hard-coded filter. So let's go ahead and erase this first of all, and let's go here. So what I like to do, for example, is what if you wanted to see all the tasks, but you wanted to quickly just see yourself? For example, what I could do is I could add a toggle here. Notice that's personal, it's called toggle one. We can change that name if we want, but we'll keep it toggle one. And we can just say, view my tasks. We can then come and put that as well in a quick call out. And then we're gonna go ahead and write a formula to reference that, and we'll see how it changes. So now I'm gonna write a formula, and I'm going to say if toggle is equal to true. So if someone actually toggles that on, what do I want to do? I want it to show it where the people, which is the assignee column, is equal to the current user. If not, I'm just gonna say true. True is just a default to like just show everything, right? But notice that that true won't show everything. It's also gonna add these together and. So true will actually show me anything that is not done. Okay, so now you'll notice I have that filter in. I've got all these different people assigned here. The moment I press view my tasks, I'm gonna see just myself. So canvas control filters are great because they just allow a different UI, and they also just allow a bit more control around filtering things, because you can also access these via buttons, you can access these via automations, right? So there's a lot more control you have over canvas filters than you do on any other piece. So they're a little harder to set up, but they give you way more flexibility and way more control. So that's filters. If you got any questions, let me know in the comments below.